Hi, Brandy. How's it going?
Can you hear me?
Hello again. Second time in less than a year is awesome.
I know. I'm happy to see you. You look as bright as you did the last time I saw you.
Oh, thank you. So you,
Yeah.
cool as always.
Thank you.
Hey, Grio fam, I'm Gerren Keith Gaynor, managing editor at theGrio. Nearly 25 years ago, Roger Hammerstein's Cinderella broke barriers with his first Black Cinderella and its multicultural and diverse cast. Now, it's heading to Disney Plus for a whole new generation. Here to talk about this very exciting news is Cinderella herself, Brandy Brianna Norwood. Brandy, thank you so much. I feel like I'm having a Cinderella moment to interview you. Two times in less than a year. I feel pretty good
about it. Oh, you're sweet. Thank you.
I want to ask you first, how does it feel to have Cinderella now on this huge platform for a whole new generation of Black girls, Black boys, Black non-gender conforming children?
I know.
See the representation that you gave over 20 years ago for a whole new generation. How does that feel?
Honestly, I don't know if I really have the word to describe what that feels like. I just know that I'm very blessed to have experienced what I experienced in 97 with Cinderella, with a multicultural cast, diverse artists from Whitney Houston to Whoopi Goldberg, Jason Alexander, all of these amazing people. Just to have that experience is just something I can keep with me forever. And then to share it with my daughter now and this new generation, I just think it's gonna touch them. It's gonna inspire them to dream bigger dreams. They're gonna love it. It's gonna bring joy to so many families because of how beautiful the music is. And it's very magical because of the timing of it all. You know, this month of February being Black History Month, and also just I'm going to be turning 42 this month, and the 12th is when it's released on Disney Plus. It's just the timing is just so, just it's splendid timing, you know, it's God timing.
I recently watched the film over again, just to remind myself of just how magical Cinderella was. I remember being a young kid in after school, we watched it, and it was a mm-hmm. big deal. And yeah. I had to remind myself that you were really young yourself. You were 17, 18 years old at that time.
I was very young.
I can imagine that it feels different this time around. That, like you said, you're about to be 42. You have mm-hmm. now a lived full life as a woman.
Yes.
Looking back on it and watching the film, like, how do you feel about it? Do you feel any differently than you did back then?
Well, I'm definitely more, I'm a full person. I know who I am, I'm connected. So I feel more grateful and appreciative for the experience, you know, because at that age, of course, I'm appreciative at that age, but you can't really grasp what's going on. I didn't understand the kind of impact that, you know, it would have at that time and, you know, what it will have this time. You know, it's just, I appreciate it so much more, you know, that I was able to be a vessel, to be, you know, an inspiration. Like, that's, at that age, you're just trying to be popular and just be famous and of course work with your idols and things like that, but you don't know what's really going on. I didn't really know. Mm. And to know now and to look back, it's like, it's unbelievable.
The last time we spoke, I asked you about Cinderella. And you mentioned that, you know, working with Whitney, you felt like you were actually living your own Cinderella story in real life.
Yes, absolutely. It was like parallel.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel to have this body of work, even though, you know, Whitney was obviously a mentor, an idol, a friend to you, you had this body of work that you can look at for the rest of your life. Memories, what does that mean to you?
It means everything to me. I mean, it's like she's a treasure, and the work that we've done is timeless. And I'm so proud of that. I can look back and see it and experience it, even moments outside of Cinderella, just us just being in the studio, us when I first met her, like all of that footage, I can go back and see and keep that and feel that, you know, and I feel her presence. Mm-hmm. It means everything to me.
And what do you love most about the story of Cinderella? Because it is a Disney film and it is a feel-good film, but it has strong messages. What do you love most about the Cinderella story?
What I love most about the Cinderella story is that she used her imagination to see herself in a better circumstance than what she was in, you know? And I love the fact that no matter how she was treated, she remained kind, she remained humble. And I think that's why so much magic was able to happen to her, because no matter what she went through, she was kind and she was able to use her imagination to see herself at the bar, see herself in better places. And I feel like that's what all little girls do. They dream of, you know, where they want to be. I know that's what I was doing. And so Cinderella just represents, is a mirror for all of us dreamers. And it's also a representation that dreams are really true and they can manifest if you believe and if you keep pushing on, you know?
Absolutely. And I also want to ask you about Natalie Desselle-Reid, who played your stepsister in Cinderella.
Yeah.
And I think it would be remiss to not mention her because she recently passed late last year.
I know.
I want to ask you, what do you remember about working with her? And more importantly, the woman she was on and off screen.
She was vibrant. Her spirit was just energetic, very funny, very down to earth. I just remember always annoying her in VN because I just wanted to be everywhere they were, you know, even scenes that I were not in, you know, I would just wanted to be around their energy. And Natalie, she was just so inspirational. And I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to speak to her. I haven't spoken to her in years and feel horrible that I didn't get a chance to say anything to her before she passed away or connect. But I know that she's with us in spirit and I know that she is gonna shine so bright in this film, and for people to see her is gonna be amazing. So yeah
she had an amazing performance in this film.
She did. Oh my god, it just hurt. She really did that.
Yeah. And as we know, Whitney chose you to be her Cinderella, and she was your fairy godmother, and she was executive producer as well. I want to ask you, if you were the fairy godmother and you were the executive producer, who would be Brandy Cinderella?
I don't know that yet. I don't know. I couldn't answer that question on a fly, but I would love to play the fairy godmother if it were to ever return. But I would have to really think about that. And when I know, I can tell you first if you want to know.
But Cinderella is also about dreams coming true. I think that's
absolutely
shines through the most. If, mm-hmm. What does Brandy dream about in 2021?
What do I dream about in 2021? Oh my God, I have so many dreams. I dream for more music, more musicals, just more creativity, just things that I've never done before. I want to do those things. And I want to go into that field of musical theater and try to bring that to television.
Awesome.
That's my plans, yeah.
I also want to tell you, I want to congratulate you on the NAACP Image
Award. Thank you, thank you.
For B7. The last time we spoke, it was right after B7 was released. And mm-hmm. you have had an amazing year. I mean, I think about the stages you were on, your performances at Billboard, at Social Awards. Oh my God. as a fan, I've been so proud and in awe of the performances that you have been putting out, both physically and vocally.
And thank you.
I feel like you're in a different pocket right now. You're in a different space. You're on a higher level. Can you speak to that? Like, are you pouring something more into yourself in a way that's different than before?
I think it's just time, you know, just everything that we've all been through. You know, I think that, you know, just having a few, we've been through a lot as, you know, as humanity, you know, we've been through so much. And I think with all of that and just, I just think for me, my spirit is just in a place of trying to be as grateful as I can be for each moment that I live. And that's really important to me because I feel like being thankful brings more things to be thankful for. And I'm just in that space right now because of everything that's happened, what we've all been through. And then also the music connecting with everybody, of course, that's made me feel amazing. But I'm definitely on a mission to continue to bring light into this world. And that's just where my head is at, honestly. Yeah.
My last question to you, Brandy, is for those who are preparing to watch this film again on February 12th, and even those who have never watched it, what do you hope they will take away from watching this film all over again or for the first time?
I just hope that it brings so much joy and love to everyone, and everyone can feel like their dreams are possible after this film, because it's really true. It's really true. And it's so magical. It is. And I just hope everybody watches this over and over and over and over and over.
Yes.
I love that.
Yes.
And Disney is home. It's the perfect home for Cinderella. Disney Plus is the perfect home for it.
Thank you so much, Brandy. Yes, dreams do come true because I'm sitting here with you time again.
Thank you. I love you. Thank you. You're great.